Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install latest version of Python on a Windows operating system. And after that, I will also show you how to write a simple HelloWorld Python program. So now to install Python, you first simply go to favorite browser and to search over here, Python download. Hit enter. So that will show you this www.python.org. So just simply go to their official site. So here you will see latest version of Python is version 3.13.3. So just simply click on this download button. You are going to download it for Windows. If you are using Linux or Mac OS, you can proceed with all these different links. And our Python is ready downloaded over here. So let's click on the show in folder. And you can see that our Python is ready downloaded over here. So just simply double click on this installer. It will open Python installation wizard. Let's minimize our download directory and our browser as well. And here you need to select both these two options and into click on custom installation. And here under optional features, you need to keep everything as default and click on next. And under advanced options, you need to select the first one, that is install Python 3.13 for all users, and keep all other things as default and click on install. That will ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes. And our Python is rightly started installing. So it will take a couple of minutes to install. By the time it gets installed, you can always follow our article about how to install latest version of Python on our official site. So this link I'm going to provide on our channel description. So in detail, I have written all the steps, you know, one by one, along with the Python download link, then step two installation, you know, all these things I have already written over here. So you can follow our article to learn more about installation of Python. And if you want to also know about different projects on Python, so that also you can learn more about, you can go through all these different projects, like turn your text into handwritten notes. So you can go through all these different articles from our official site, along with you can also go through this playlist. So here I have created some cool Python projects. I'm going to upload more in coming days. So you can watch all these different, you know, projects that I have created on Python to learn more about Python. All right. So yeah, so here let's wait for some more time. So we'll come back. And now you can clearly see that our Python is rightly installed. You can click on close now. And now if you go to search and just simply type cmd to open our command prompt. And within command prompt, if you just simply type python space dash dash version and just simply hit enter, it's going to show you this latest version of Python over here. So if you get this type of prompt, then all that basically means is your Python is rightly installed on your system. Now let's do a bit of coding. So just go to search and invoke our Python idle shell. So just simply type idle. So that will show you this Python idle over here. So just simply click on that, and that will open our Python idle shell over here. So here you can write simple Python program, something like print hello within double quote, and just simply hit enter, you're going to get that output. You can also create a new file and write simple Python program. So let's, you know, print couple of number. So let's add couple of number and print them. So let's add, you know, a plus b. So I have assigned this value of 6 and 5 to each variable, and I'm going to print summation of these two number, that is a plus b. So after that, I'm going to click on file and click on save as. And on our desktop, I'm going to save this file as sum.py. I'm going to click on save. So our file is rightly saved. Now if you go to run and click on run module, you're going to get that output coming over here. So 6 plus 5, that is 11. So that is what we are doing over here, and that output is coming over here, right? 11. So in this way, you can, you know, start working on your Python projects right on Python idle shell. I'll also recommend you to install PyCharm. So you can follow this video to install PyCharm. And once you have PyCharm, you can follow all these videos on our channel to learn about these different Python projects. And you can always follow our article, our website, you know, to learn more about all these different projects that I have, you know, created, and in detail notes along with entire source code you will get on our website as well. Alright, so yeah, so that's basically all about this video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and press that bell button to get notified. So thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.